I begin, I would like to inform you guys that this is a very sensitive and delicate subject, and it is not my intent to offend anyone or make anybody feel uncomfortable. A guy meets a girl at a party or any function. Instantly they click and they start to see that they have some type of interest towards each other, and they decide to go to a secluded room to continue their conversation. There might or might not have been any alcohol involved, but either way they just continue talking, and suddenly the guy or girl starts feeling a little weak and out of it. And the guy or girl then proceeds to make sexual advancements towards the other person, who protests and struggles and repeats no because they just don't want to be approached that type of way. And then the other person proceeds to rape the other person and then leaves. The victim might or might not report this incident. This is an example of date rape, and it is the most frequent and reported form of rape. What is date rape? Date rape is often referred to as acquaintance rape, which is assault or attempted assault committed by someone that you have met socially, somebody that you are not related to, somebody who's not your family member. And this person makes you have sex with them without your consent, whether or not you are under the influence of alcohol. This is common in college campuses, so my purpose is to inform you about the effects of date rape, the motives of the people who commit this crime, some statistics, and why we should all speak up for ourselves and for other people as well. Some of the effects of date rape are nightmares, where you replay the incident in your mind over and over again. Fear and confusion. Guilt, some anger towards the person who did this to you. Regret, why was I at this party? Why was I talking to this person? Why didn't I see this coming? Emotional breakdown, including post-traumatic stress disorder. Trust issues, because you see the attacker and everybody else that you meet. Shame, because you feel as though a precious part of you was taken away from you. And doubt as well. Most people wait day to day to have sex, rapists go and make it happen. Why do people commit such crimes? The people who commit this crime often do it to feel powerful, complete, and in control. Bad influences as well as bad atmospheres can lead to people committing these crimes. Sometimes there are even no motives. People just do it because they're dangerous, or they just do it to make themselves feel better. According to the Rape, Abuse, and Incest National Network, 9 out of every 10 rape victims were female, and 1 out of every 10 rape were men in 2003. Women go through it more than men do, but men do as well. They're just not as open about it as women are. According to the University of Kansas Counseling Services, between 15 and 30% of college women have been the victim of acquaintance rape at some point in their lives, which means that you might have been through it, or you know someone who has. A 2000 Bureau of Justice Statistics study reveals that 90% of college rape survivors have known their attacker before the incident, which means that you have seen this person somewhere, or you have met them before. In an article titled Preventing Date Rape, it is estimated that only 25% of rapes are reported, because victims after such an incident feel a great deal of shame and a great deal of guilt, which is why they never come forward. What can you do to help someone who experienced date rape? You can be a source of support by helping them trust you so that they can seek counseling, by telling the police or telling a family member so that justice can be served. You can also be a voice among your community and be an advocate for this cause, and just teach people about this so that you can also teach yourself about this. I will leave you with this. Whenever you go to a party, please be mindful of your surroundings, and also be very careful about leaving your drinks unattended. I hope you all enjoyed my presentation. Thank you.